Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. On this sunny afternoon, I have a very, very special, interesting feature at KyaBae. Do you want to know what the future of litigation and court and dispute looks like? Well, that's exactly what we are going to explore today. The Prerna Foundation, in association with KyaBae, is very, very proud to present to you in conversation with Mr. Prathamesh D. Popat, and I have the privilege to introduce him to you today. He is the founder of Prachi Resolutionary, Educatory and Conflict Handling Initiatives. He is a member of the Bombay Bar Association, the leading organization of practicing lawyers. He started his practice as a counsel at the Bombay High Court in the chambers of Aspi P. Chinoy Senior Counsel. He was empaneled as a mediator at the Bombay High Court in 2003. He was trained and accredited by LEADR and certified by IMI, the International Mediation Institute. He's also the chairman of the Mediation and Conciliation Committee of the IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry. And of course, he is the founding member of the Association of Mediation Practitioners. I am honored to bring to you Mr. Prathamesh D. Popat. Welcome to our show.
Thank you.
Today the talk is about the very, very big change in the legal industry, which is moving towards what we would like to call alternative dispute resolution, but it's actually slowly becoming the appropriate dispute resolution. And we have some questions to ask for Mr. Popat over here, and we'll get right on to it. So, we would like to know, what are the different ways in which a legal dispute in this country can be resolved today?
Basically, you can either resolve it through adjudicatory means, which is you go to the courts of law and file a suit. If you have a contract in which there is a dispute resolution clause for arbitration, then you would be required to go for arbitration and appoint an arbitrator who would be like your private judge and take the matter before him. The other mode is the class of resolutionary means, the processes where you use a collaborative method to resolve disputes, where unlike a court of law or an arbitration, you have a neutral who is named either a mediator or a conciliator. And he would sit with the parties and help them talk things out to a point where they settle on terms they can mutually agree with.
That's amazing. That means that we do not have to go to court and we can choose to settle things outside of court without actually having to go and face those hassles. So do you think that is the best practice for a common man to solve disputes today?
Except for cases which require a precedential value, certainly. In my view, just about 99.99% of disputes can be resolved and should be resolved in a resolutionary way rather than an adjudicatory way.
So, Mr. Popat, please explain to us in brief, how does this mediation process work exactly? Because we are really not aware of it.
Okay. So, whether we call it mediation or you call it conciliation, the process is by and large the same. It's swimming, whether you call it backflip, backstroke, freestyle, breaststroke, whatever, it's still swimming. So the nomenclature, whatever the words you use, the process remains virtually the same, that it is a collaborative process. Here, the parties come together and voluntarily start the process by appointing a mediator or a conciliator and take things forward before him, who has the skills of getting the parties to be at it till they get it. So, the skills require the mediator to bring his skills of communication to the table, and sometimes he could be having also some domain knowledge in expertise in the field from which the dispute arises, and in such situations he would be probably better off as a conciliator to help parties add speed to the process to get a resolution sooner than you would in a what you call a plain vanilla mediation process.
So do we still need a lawyer for this process?
It's up to the parties. If they feel they are confident, then they can take things forward. And rightly so, you don't take permission of your lawyers to start a dispute. Why would you require a lawyer's permission to settle a dispute? However, the law being what it is and the rigmaroles down the line, one may not know. So it's a good thing to have a lawyer to guide you to resolve it and put it into paper, whatever be your resolution, in such a way that later on, should it be required, you can enforce it in a court of law without any hassles.
So mediation is definitely an easy and a faster process to get your dispute settled. But sir, tell us something, are these settlement agreements binding on the parties?
When parties resolve a matter, they do it on the terms they mutually agree to live with. And it's only because they are in agreement with those terms that they choose to settle it on those terms and put it in ink and sign on the dotted lines. That being so, there really is no need for enforcement of these judgments. Like the clothes that I ironed last night, I suddenly don't change unless situations change. So by and large, you don't require to enforce them. At the same time, there are also some nuances of a dispute resolution where down the line circumstances change, maybe the officer changes in the company which has signed this agreement, and therefore there might be a change in the mindset, and therefore people may feel like reneging from their obligations that they have entered into. In such scenarios, it's a good thing to have take recourse to the Arbitration and Conciliation Act of 1996, wherein under Part 3 you can start a conciliation process should your matter fall within the parameters of those provisions, where at the end of it, process remains the same. You just call the mediator a conciliator and follow the tenets of the provisions of that Part 3 of the 96 Act, and at the end, whatever will be the outcome, it's a conciliated settlement agreement which is binding and enforceable in a court of law. Therefore, you will require to go to the court, but only for execution, which could be just a year or two maybe, not like a normal suit which takes 25-30 years, at least in the Bombay High Court, it does take that long. So that's a very good bet. But again, to repeat, that usually that hardly ever happens. Parties do not agree to sign if they are not agreeable to the terms that they are signing for.
In short, in a mediation, you are eventually doing something that you yourself have opted for at the very beginning. You yourself have signed up for. So therefore, violations are very, very rare, and therefore going to court becomes a very, very only one in a million chance. That's amazing, and mediation can definitely ease up our legal processes. Where do we find these mediators? How does one become a mediator?
Mediator is a person who has the skills of communication. That's the only skill he brings to the table, by and large. And this skill is born out of common sense, born out of the basic principles of communication. But in addition, you are trained in specialized 40-hour mediators basic training courses to help parties get out of the pitfalls if at least they cannot avoid them in the first place. So if you take these trainings, then you get the skills to help parties to be at it till they get it. And that's the charm of these trainings, to teach you those communication skills.
Are there many training institutions around?
Yes, there are quite a few. Of course, abroad, across the globe, there are several. To mention, we have got Pepperdine, Harvard giving these trainings. We have got several chambers of commerce. We have got several specialized ADR institutes like LEADER, which is now Resolution Institute in Australia. CEDAR in UK, ADR Group again in UK, and in India too, we have got quite a few institutes mushrooming. Of late we have seen IICA, that's the institute connected to the Corporate Affairs Ministry. They are also giving these trainings across our country, and there are also these local chambers. Like I also give this training in under the banner of my chamber, Prachi Mediation Chambers, and I give 40-hour basic course as also advanced courses on request. So there are several institutes which do give these courses.
So is that all you do as far as training is concerned?
No. In addition, I also, as you mentioned, I'm connected to several institutes. The Indian Merchants Chamber has set up an ADR center. Just yesterday, we have launched a new organization, the Association of Mediation Practitioners. Here, we institutionalize the whole service of mediation practice, where mediators are on the one hand trained, and on the other hand, we put them on the panel and have rules which parties adopt and come to these organizations to help them to get their issues resolved amicably. And having the rules before you gives you a fair idea of what to expect down the line.
That's amazing. Now, mediation we have established is definitely the easier and faster way. But what do you think, there must be a few challenges that the people who opt for mediation might be facing. What are those?
The challenges are homegrown. I am a lawyer, and my colleagues in the legal profession, they are one major challenge. We have this thing called ADR, and in my profession, they call it alarming decline in revenue. And rightly so. A case which could get you 120, 30, 50 hours of billable time in a court of law suddenly gets resolved in 5, 7 hours, then it's bound to hit your belly. But this is just a temporary phase, and this happens in every society that moves from doing adjudicatory processes to now taking up resolutionary processes. There is a little flux in between where you do find and do feel that yes, you are losing out. But down the line, what happens is that as people realize that yes, here I am getting a resolution quite easily, very quickly, very swiftly, effectively, efficaciously, then more and more people would be coming forward to get their disputes resolved in a amicable way, in institutionalized manner, rather than live with them and just suffer their fate. And that's we have seen happening in Australia, in several of the states in USA, and now and soon in India also we will be seeing this happening, where more and more matters will be getting resolved through mediation, and therefore we will not be having this ADR being called as alarming decline in revenue.
I think that is definitely the key point here, that today conflicts happen everywhere. But how many of us actually choose to go down the legal route to solve that conflict, to resolute that conflict? I think what mediation is going to do is people will start asking more questions and choosing the legal path, since it is really making the legal path so much easier to handle. And therefore, lawyers will have so many more cases at their doorstep. That is absolutely a revolutionary change in the legal industry. Currently, mediation is not mandatory in India. But how important is the requirement for mediation legislation in India? And do you think it will have some future as arbitration then?
Firstly, one very senior mediator, a retired chief justice in Australia, mentioned that to define mediation is to confine mediation. That being so, it's not really a good thing to have a legislation, elaborate one, to regulate mediation practices. It is good enough to have a little bare-bone skeletal structure of a legislation of just a couple of pages, which gives you a broad outline as to who is not a mediator and who cannot do mediation. You know, a few do's and don'ts, that's fine. But elaborate legislation is really not required. Secondly, mediation need not be mandatory. It doesn't have to be, and it must never be. If you have a toothache, it's not mandatory for you to go to a dentist, but you do land up in this chair. Same way, if you have a dispute and once services are available, people will immediately rush to them. You don't need to tell them so. You just need to make the services available and let them know that they are available here at this place. That's all.
That is amazing. And lastly, I'm very sure a lot of the viewers watching this video are budding lawyers. What kind of advice would you give these lawyers in the field of mediation?
Firstly, don't make a mistake. Remember this, that mediation cannot be a day job, not today. That being so, keep your revenue stream alive and flourishing so that you do get your work from elsewhere. And slowly you will find, as the culture takes shape and takes root, that everybody is slowly moving towards resolutionary practices, where you will be having what we call multi-tiered clauses in our transactions, where the contracts have a dispute resolution clause, where parties would first try out negotiation, then try out mediation, then try out arbitration before going to the court of law. All these things will not only get more sophisticated down the line, they will also move from being ad hoc to getting institutionalized. And thirdly, you will find that you are having better and better mediators being available, where just the flick of a button you could check up their credentials at several places and even pick the right one for that type of dispute. So that what our one professor Peter Sanders said in the US, see what fits the fuss. And therefore you would be having a choice, a plethora of choices as to which process of the collaborative style should you pick for the kind of dispute that your client is suffering.
Thank you so much, sir. It was an honor interviewing you, and thank you for being a part of
thank
our special feature.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, a revolution is at our hands. The legal industry is about to change. People who have conflicts in front of them but do not want to use the legal paths to solve them are scared and think they will take too much time. I think mediation is the perfect answer for their troubles. And we can really see mediation growing to become a very, very popular mode of solving our disputes in the future, even in this country. I thank you, Mr. Prathamesh D. Popat, for coming here and for teaching us in such simple words how mediation will really affect our lives in the future. With enthusiasts like you, I'm sure that India will soon have a world-class dispute resolution mechanism right here for all of us to use. Thank you so much for tuning in to this special feature. See you soon.
Thank you.